Hi YouTube, welcome to MA Academy C++ Pointers Tutorial Series. In this tutorial, I will show you guys what is a pointer to a pointer to a pointer. So what is a pointer to a pointer to a pointer? So this is a pointer to a pointer to a pointer. Now we have, whenever we declare a variable, so let's say we have a variable, we say int num is equal to 2123. So this 2123 gets assigned a block of memory. And of course, this block of memory will have an address. So next, what we do, we create a pointer. So we say p is equal to num. So we are using the address of num. So it means that whatever the address of this block of memory is, this p will contain that. So it means that p is pointing to that address of memory. Next, we are saying int q is equal to address of p. So it means that this q in here, we can see that it is pointing to what? P in here. So, what does it mean? There is this q, which is pointing to another pointer, which is pointing to this address in here. That's why we use two asterisks in here, because it's already pointing, a pointer is already pointing to it. So we use this pointer, and then we have our own pointer, which is pointing to it. So we use two asterisks in here. Then we declare another variable, another pointer, and we are saying r. So this time we use three asterisks. So we are saying this pointer is a pointer that is pointing to this pointer, which again is pointing to this pointer, which is pointing to this variable in here. So it is a pointer to a pointer to a pointer. It's a pointer to a pointer to pointer, because this is a pointer, this is a pointer, and this is a pointer. So whenever we point a pointer to a pointer, so we increase the number of asterisks. Since this q is pointing to a pointer, we use two asterisks, and since this r is using to two pointers, we in here we can see that we use these three asterisks in here. So how does it get represented on the memory? So let's look at this in here. So we said that this num gets assigned a chunk of memory, and this block of memory will have an address, right? So let's say that the address of this memory is 100 and C. Then we say what? Int p is equal to the address of num. So what does it mean? It means that p should contain the address of num. So the address of num, here we can see is 100 and C. So p, what? P contains the address of this in here, num. So this is what p does. P points to the address of num. Next, what we do, next we say int q is equal to address of p. So what does it mean? It means whatever the address of p is, which in this case is 1008, that's what q should contain. So this q is what? 1008. Since 1008 is the address of p, we are saying q is equal to address of p. So this is 1008. Then we say what? Int r is equal to address of q. So what is the address of q? It's 1004. So r should contain the address of q. So in here we can see that r is equal to 1004. However, since we can see that all these pointers, they reside inside the memory, they will have their own addresses, right? So that's why we can see that this pointer has its own address, this pointer has its own address, and this pointer has its own address. So what happens when we print it? So in here you can see that when I say, so look at this program in here. The first thing I'm doing is I'm declaring this, declaring and initializing this variable called num. Then I'm saying this pointer p is equal to num. Then this pointer q is equal to address of p. And then this pointer r is equal to the address of q. So when I say print c out r, what does it mean? It means to show me the address of r. So let's look at the diagram again. So I will explain it with the help of this first, because this way it will probably make more sense, because the addresses are short in here. Now, when I say show me the address of r, it prints what? 1000. Why? Because this 1000 is the address of r. Then I say print r. So what does it mean? It means print the contents of r. So what is the contents of r? So the contents of the r is 1004. Then I say print asterisk r. So what does it mean? It means show me the contents of whatever the r is pointing to. So in here, r is pointing to q, and its contents is 1008. Then we use two asterisks. So what does it mean? It means show me the contents of the pointer to a pointer. So in this case, it contains 100c. So when we run this, it shows me the contents of it. So the first time that we use the ampersand, it shows me the address of the r. Then we don't use an ampersand, it shows me the contents of r. So when we use one asterisk, it shows me the contents of the node to the right of it. So think of it, when we use one asterisk, it means that go one node to the right and show me the contents of that variable or that pointer. When I use two asterisk, it means that go two nodes to the right. So in here we go two nodes to the right, and when we print it, you can see that it prints 100 and C, which is this one. And then when we use three asterisk, it means that we should go three nodes to the right. So this is one, this is two, and this is three. So when we run it, we get 2123 printed on the screen. So we can look at it this way as well. So when we use one R in here, you can see that it shows me the contents of this. We go one times, one place to the right. When we use two asterisks, we go two places to the right. And then we use three asterisks, we go three places to the right. By the way, ignore this Q. This is not Q, this is R. It's just a misspelling in here, a typo. So this should be R. So let's look at the program now. So in here, let's look at it. So when I first say print this in here, so what does it contain? It contains the address of R, right? So let's quickly run this. So in here we can see that the address of R is this. Then I say show me the contents of R. So it shows me the contents of R. So you can see that this is the contents of R. So the contents of R is the address of Q, right? So these two are the same. So in here, if you look at this, it means that this is the address of Q. So let's quickly go in here and say show me the address of Q. So when we do it and when we run it, so you can see that these two are the same, because R contains the address of Q, just like in here we see R contains the address of Q. Then we move one more time to the right, and then we are saying show me the contents of one times R. So what does it contain? This contains, when we go one node to the right, it is 1008. What is it? This is the address of P. So when we do a cout and we say P and do an NL, so let's quickly run this again. So we can see that these two addresses are the same, because when we use this asterisk R, it means that show me the contents of the node, or we can say that whatever is to the right of it. So it is easier to think of it that way. So this is Q, and show me the contents of it. The contents of the Q is what? P. So if you look at this in here, this is R, this is Q. So Q is pointing to P, so it shows me the value of that one in here. Next, when we say in here, show me the contents of this R in here, it means show me the address of P, num, sorry. So when we do that, and L, so we should see that they are both the same thing. So in here, let's run it. So in here, you can see that these two addresses are the same. Why? Because I said two asterisks. So you can think of it, this is one asterisk, one time to the right, then two times to the right. So what is this? This is 100 and C. So 100 and C is the address of num. So in here you can see that when I print these two lines, they contain the same address. Next I say print this asterisk, 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 R. So it means that show print me whatever this R is pointing to. So R is pointing to a pointer, to a pointer, to a pointer. So sorry, it's a pointer to a pointer to a pointer, which again, it's a pointer to a pointer to a pointer, which again is pointing to this variable in here, which is 2123. So when we run it, we can see that we get 2123 printed on the screen. Wow, man. So this is it for this one, guys. If you have any questions, suggestions, and recommendations, feel free to post it or put it in the comment section below. And if you found this tutorial useful, make sure to share it with your friends. And I will see you guys in the next one.